Hello and welcome to Linear Algebra. This is the first part in a series of videos I will do about linear algebra. The content here is the same that is usually taught to first year students at the university. Therefore, I will start with the basic mathematics and then we will go deeper into the subject of linear algebra. Now I give you a quick overview about mathematical logic and set theory. I guess most people have a good intuitive feeling about everyday logic. However, in mathematics, we have to define everything in an unambiguous way, and therefore we give here a foundation for the notations and a basic rule of the so-called propositional logic. Hence, we start with a definition where I will say what I mean by a logical statement, or in short, by a proposition. A proposition is now just a statement, and by a statement, I mean a meaningful declarative sentence. And also, the statement should have a well-defined truth value, which means that it is either true or false. So that is either true or false. For shortening notations, I will use a capital T for true, or maybe a 1, and for false the same as a capital F or a 0. As you can see, we are now indeed in the world of mathematics, since we are only considering statements that has a well-defined truth value. So there are no opinions, no alternative facts, no self-contradictory statements, just statements that are either true or false. I won't go into details that even in mathematics we will stumble upon so-called undecidable statements that don't have a well-defined truth value, since they don't concern us here in the basic linear algebra course. So all statements we will have, all propositions, will have a well-defined truth value. Another problem we will have now is to give examples. Examples outside of mathematics, so logical statements, which I formulate using the English language, may have some problems of definition or some ambiguous interpretation. However, if you allow some background knowledge, we will find very good examples. For example, here, Paris is a city, is a good logical proposition. And since we know what a city is, we can say this logical statement is a true one. So has the truth value true. Maybe the next one is the number 5 is smaller than 2. There is no problem with this. This is a well-defined logical statement. But this one, as you all know, is a false one. Next example, good morning. Very nice, but of course it has no truth value, so this is not a logical statement. Next one, D. X plus 1 is equal to 1. This one might be a tricky one. It seems like a sensible statement, but as you can see, it doesn't have a well-defined truth value. It depends on x. If x is 0, this will be a true statement, and if x is, for example, minus 1, it would be a false statement. Therefore, in short, it is not a logical statement, but it is very close. Hence, it gets a logical statement if we choose a value for x. So if we choose a value for the variable x here. This is an example of what we will call later a predicate. Another example of such a predicate would be example E. Today is Tuesday. Again, seems like a very nice sentence, but it's not a logical statement since today depends on the day I say the sentence. Therefore, it may be true or false, so it has no well-defined truth value. Again, it's a predicate. Now, today is our X. Hence, I can say the same as before. And predicates will be very important later, but now we will focus only on logical statements. And for doing this, we need more definitions for defining logical operations. Here, A and B should be arbitrarily chosen logical statements. And now we can do some things with A and B, combine them or negate them. Negation is the first one I consider here. To denote this, we will use this sign right in front of A. And this is what we call, in short, not A. Not A is now just defined as the opposite of A, which means that not A is true if and only if A is false. For better understanding, we can simply do a so-called truth table. So we're putting in all the possible values for A, and this would be 1 or 0, or just true or false. Maybe I use some colors. So true is green and false is red. So A can have these two values. So it can be true or false. And not A is just the opposite. It means if A is true, then not A would be false. And if A is false, then not A is true. In the spoken language, we can just use the word not to negate this logical statement. For example, Paris is a city. The negation, not A, would be Paris is not a city. Or I give you another example. All students are in the lecture hall. This would be our logical statement A. And not A is now given by the following sentence. Not all students are in the lecture hall. Okay, this seems a bit unnatural, maybe. No one speaks like this. So we can rewrite this as the following. There is a student, so at least one, that is not in a lecture hall. This is the same thing. This is not A. And we will come back to this construction later. But here you can see, with putting in a not in a sentence, you can form the negation of our logical statement. Most of the time, this will make sense. However, still be careful. For example, a bottle of water is full as a logical statement. The negation is not that the bottle of water is empty. Of course, the negation would be the bottle of water is not full. So it could be half full, for example. Okay, enough of negation. Now we go to conjunction. Of course, conjunction will combine two propositions A and B. The symbol one uses for this is this wedge. So A and B. So this is what we call it. A and B. So both things together. There you already see the meaning of the conjunction. Both logical propositions have to hold simultaneously. Now we can fix this in the truth table. So here A and B. So this would be the definition of A and B depending on the truth values of A and B. So we have two possibilities for A, true and false. Maybe I write them in this way. So true, true, false, false. And then for B, it could be true and A could be true. Or if A is true, B is false. So this would be two possibilities. And the same the other way around here. False, true and false, false. And now A and B means it's only true if both things are true simultaneously. So this would be true if A and B are true. And in all other cases, it is false. False, false, false. Here you can see the logical representation of AND. And now we do the same for OR. And this is what we call this junction of A and B. And the symbol is the same as for AND, just the other way around. So the wedge flipped. This is the logical OR. A OR B. This means that this statement would be true if at least one of them is true. For showing this, I can just simply copy my truth table from above, and now we have the OR, the disjunction here. Okay, A and B true means, yeah, both are true, the disjunction is also true. A true, B false means A is true, therefore the disjunction gives you also true. And the same if B is true. You only need one of them to be true. And if both A and B are false, then also the disjunction would be false. So keep in mind, this is no excluding OR, so no either this or that. If both are true, the disjunction is also true. As you can see, these are important short notations, and of course, in mathematics, we will use them a lot. I will finish with the last two, where a very important one is the implication. And there I will use the symbol with the right arrow to the right, so A arrow to B. And we would simply say A implies B. Of course, I just copy again our truth table from above, and now we look at the implication A to B. So we want to look at two values of A and follow from this two values for B. So this should be a true implication. However, if A is true and this would imply wrong things for B, this can't be true, so this would be a false implication. Now in mathematics we have a good convention for the other two cases. So what happens if A is already false? What does the implication to B mean? The idea is now, from wrong assumptions I'm able to deduce everything. And therefore this should be also a true implication, simply because our assumptions A are false in the beginning. So, but the important cases are of course these two here. If our assumption is true, what happens for the implication if B is true or false? So very quick, the implication. Now we can do the equivalence. Here we will use the symbol as the arrow in both directions. So we have again a symmetric order here, and we simply say A is equivalent to B. Here the idea is that equivalence should hold if both implications hold. So we have the implication A to B and the implication B to A. Of course, we already know the values here, so this is 2, 2, 2, and only false if we have a true assumption and false B here. And we can do the same on the other side. So here B and A are true, so this is true. This is also true, since false assumption, but here we have the wrong outcome and a true assumption, so this one is the false one. This implication. This one is true, therefore green. Okay, as I said, equivalence means both implications hold. So here this one holds and this one holds, so our equivalence is true. And here you can see, maybe I need again blue, so this one is false, but this is true, therefore we have here false. Here the other way around, B to A is false, therefore also the equivalence is false. And here you can see, again, both implications are true, and therefore the equivalence is also true. Or in other words, A and B are equivalent when they have the same truth value. So both are true or both are false, but not the mixed ones. Very, very good. Now we have all the definitions we need for our propositional logic. Now we can do mathematics. You may already know that in mathematics, it's important that we can deduce new stuff from old stuff. So we start with some axioms, things, statements that are supposed to be true. And then we want to do some logical steps to get to new true statements. In order to do this in a useful manner, we will need some simple deduction rules. And this is what we will do in the next video. So, thanks for listening.